are gods, we are kings. We march in faith cause we believe we can change the world to what it needs. Stand against our enemies cause we can. Yeah, can't nothing ever stop us. Take one and another will rise up. We'll endure until we reach the end. End. We are gods, we are kings, demanding change cause we believe we can.
Let me ask you a question. You've been to Jerusalem, you've been to Israel, right?
Yes.
Where is Israel on the continent of this, where is Israel? Where is it located? North, east, south, west, where is it located? Hey, listen, don't be prideful, you can say, I don't know.
No, seriously, I'm a retired military, I've been a lot of places.
Oh, okay. It's in the northern part of Africa. All right, it's in the northeast type area. That is where Jerusalem is located, above the lower parts of Africa, which is known as what? Lower Egypt, Upper Egypt, Lower Egypt. That's what it's known as. All right, so Jerusalem is located in the northeastern part. But let's find out something. Read
Galatians chapter 4, verse 26. But Jerusalem, which is above, is free.
Come on, Jerusalem, which is above, is free. Which is above what? Which is above all nations on the earth. Come on.
Right. Which is.
Which what?
Which is the mother of us all.
Because what you have is people migrating different places based on the seas. They took ships. They took ships to get to these different places. Right. It wasn't because there was on this one part, the earth started breaking away and shifting away from each other at 2 inches a year, because that's what the mathematically geographical status is of landmass moving away from each other. That it moves away from each other at a rate of about 2 inches per year. Okay, that is not how your homeland is determined. Jerusalem is our homeland. The reason we ended up in Africa and on slave ships and then in America is because during 70 AD, we fled Roman persecution.
Luke chapter 21, verse 20.
Come on.
And when ye shall see Jerusalem compassed with armies.
So this is Christ prophesying about what is going to take place in Jerusalem in the near future. Read.
Then know that the desolation thereof is not.
Desolation is destruction. Christ told the people during that time. He told the apostles, when you see Jerusalem in compassed with armies, know that the destruction for breaking God's commandments, that the destruction of Jerusalem is near. Read.
Then let them which are in Judea flee to the mountains.
So if you got Judea here and you got Upper Egypt and Lower Egypt here, which is now known as what? Africa. And he said what? Flee where?
Flee to the mountains.
What would be the mountains from the northeast of this continent, Jerusalem? What would be the mountains? That, my brother, would be Africa as it is known today.
Right.
That is where we ran to, and at that time, this was not known as Africa.
Right.
All right? So we ran fleeing Roman persecution. Come on.
And let them which are in the midst of it depart out.
So Christ said, don't go back into Jerusalem when you see this happening. Read on.
And let not them that are in the countries enter therein too.
Read.
For these be the days of vengeance, that all things which are written may be fulfilled.
So these are the days of vengeance, meaning the destruction and the punishment for breaking God's commandments is going to happen. Let's go to the beginning, because Egypt was before the Roman era, right? The Egyptian era. Okay, so now, how did we end up in Egypt?
You don't want my definition.
The Bible gives a definition.
I'm an atheist.
Okay, all praises. All this time now you're an atheist.
No, I've been an atheist the whole time.
Let's read.
I already said you couldn't convert me.
Let's read this.
Front.
Okay, read that.
Exodus chapter 1, verse 5.
Read it up.
And all the souls that came out of the loins of Jacob were 70 souls. Uh-huh. For Joseph was in Egypt already.
How did Joseph end up in Egypt? His brother sold him to the Egyptians.
Right.
And while he was in Egypt, he got set up as the greatest man under Pharaoh in Egypt. So now it's explaining how many souls came into Egypt because their brother was already there. Come on.
And Joseph died,
uh-huh.
and all his brethren and all that generation.
Yep.
And the children of Israel were fruitful,
uh-huh.
and increased abundantly.
So in Egypt, we were fruitful, meaning we had children and multiplied increasingly. Come on.
And multiplied and waxed exceeding mighty.
Uh-huh.
And the land was filled with them.
The land was full of Hebrews, Israelites in Egypt. Come on.
Now there arose up a new king
Now a new king is set up in Egypt. Come on.
Which knew not Joseph.
He didn't know Joseph. Why? Because Joseph is dead. Come on.
And he said unto his people, behold, the people of the children of Israel.
You blacks, Hispanics, and Native Indians. Come on.
Are more and mightier than we.
It's more than them, and they're mightier than us. Come on.
Come on. Let us deal wisely with them.
We need to have a council. Let's find out how we're going to deal with these children of Israel. Come on.
Right. Lest they multiply.
Lest they keep multiplying.
And it come to pass,
uh-huh.
that when there falleth out any war,
uh-huh.
they join also unto our enemies.
So their fear was that if enemy came against them, that we would join the enemy that was that would be against the Egyptians, and we would join them. Come on.
Right.
And fight against us.
Come on.
And so get them up out of the land.
Read on.
Therefore they did set over them taskmasters.
So now the Egyptians are setting up over the children of Israel taskmasters. What's a taskmaster?
That's 2,000 years later.
No, wait a minute. This is all of this is happening in the present time.
Right.
Not over. This is going on. Let me ask you.
The Israelites.
Who is he's dead?
Right, but that was dead. It was 2,000 years into Egyptian culture.
Who cares about the number? The number doesn't make a difference. What matters is the children of Israel were already in Egypt, and the new Pharaoh set up taskmasters over these people. So let me ask you, what is a taskmaster?
That is a slave.
That's an enslaver, like Bernie. Bernie is your taskmaster right now.
Therefore, they did set over them taskmasters to afflict them.
To do what?
To afflict them.
So these taskmasters were set up to afflict the children of Israel. Come on.
With their burdens.
With burdens. Come on.
And they built for Pharaoh treasure cities.
So now we get to the pyramids and who built these pyramids. Because Egyptians did not build all the pyramids.
Right.
Read.
Pithom and Ramses.
Pithom and Ramses still stand in Egypt today.
Right.
Read.
But the more they afflicted them,
uh-huh.
the more they multiplied and
so
grew.
So now you go to Egypt and you go inside of these temples or these pyramids, you see hieroglyphics or the ancient term Medunetta. You see this Medunetta written on the walls, but there's something wrong with this Medunetta or hieroglyphics. It has been whitewashed.
Right.
It no longer displays black people and black people and their burdens.
Now
it's been whitewashed. You see a white face with little black fingers.
Right.
Why is that? Because they are taking away and whitewashing the history like they've always done.
Right.
Read.
Psalms chapter 105, verse 17.
Come on.
He sent a man before them,
uh-huh.
even Joseph, who was sold for a servant.
So he sent the man before the children of Israel, Joseph, come on.
Whose feet they hurt with fetters.
Uh-huh.
He was laid in iron until the time that his word came. The word of the Lord tried him. The king sent and loosed him, even the ruler of the people, and let him go free. He made him lord over his house,
uh-huh.
and ruler of all his substance.
Come on.
To bind his princes at his pleasure,
uh-huh.
and teach his senators wisdom.
So this is Joseph. Joseph taught his senators wisdom. Joseph ruled under Pharaoh and during this time.
So I got to make sure I'm clear. So the Israelites, the Judeans, was the original people.
Yes.
They had an advanced culture.
Yes.
I'm not being funny. I'm trying to find out. So what historically marks
their culture as advanced culture, right? Because the pyramids ain't it. Pyramids are
Historically marks the Israelites' culture as advanced culture?
Yeah, what region?
I'm gonna give you a prime example. The curses of this Bible only fit one particular people on this earth.
Right.
But since you don't believe the Bible or believe in God, none of that is gonna make sense to you anyway.
Right.
Now, once we fled Roman persecution and ended up in what is known as Africa, we started doing some things. We started setting up our own culture. We started setting up our own laws. We started setting up ourselves according to how we were in our land. Read that.
Babylon to Timbuktu, page 90.
Read it.
By historical facts, 100%, like you said.
What I'm saying is,
the black Jews had an advantage over the African tribe.
Well, why do we have an advantage? Let's find out. Read.
They carried their culture.
Their what?
Their culture.
So even these people who are now known today as Africans know that we had a culture. That's why they don't accept us as Americans over here now. Because they know we ain't the same people.
Right.
They know we're not them.
Right.
Read.
Hold they on. Carried their culture, history, laws, and written records
that
with
what?
Them.
Their what?
Laws and written records with them.
Come on.
This assured them a constant precedent for the development of a higher social organization.
So we came to their land and set up a higher socialization system. Read.
Because of the stability of the black Jewish culture, the Jews were not absorbed into autochthonous population.
Unlike today, we are absorbed into what America has to offer us.
Right.
We are absorbed into Bernie. We are absorbed into Trump. We are absorbed into voting instead of being absorbed into the words of God.
Right, right. In fact, the Jews absorbed some of their native tribes.
Uh-huh.
The Jews made use of every opportunity.
So it says that we absorbed, we brought in, they adhered to our laws when they came in. The native tribes, we absorbed them into our customs. Come on.
They were an industrious and skillful people.
We were an industrious and skillful people, unlike today. Read.
In the Jewish Ghanaian states were found kings.
Were found what?
Kings.
Come on.
Princes, governors, generals, secretaries, treasurers, revenue agents, judges, architects, engineers, doctors, historians, language interpreters, mathematicians, jewelers, sculptors, masons, carpenters, painters of art, goldsmiths, leather workers, potters, armorers, saddlers, blacksmiths, agriculturalists, etc.
Is that enough to prove that we are the Jews that settled in a foreign land which is known as they got different names for that part of Africa right now. This is in the midst of Africa. This was in the midst of Africa. You can go there right now and you will see different, what is called, landmarks and different agricultural representation that we were there.
My question is, from the original people, what historically can I turn to?
The Bible?
No, it's got to be physical present, because what you're talking about is society. So that's what I'm asking.
See,
I'm not trying to be funny. That's what I'm asking. What societal?
You have to get like, me to get me Jeremiah chapter 17 and verse 4. Real quick.
The temples.
This is what you got to understand. Because we were rebellious, we lost everything.
Right.
We lost everything except for our innate spirit to serve the Most High.
Right.
We still have that innate spirit to serve the Most High, but Most High had our forefathers write our history.
Right.
This is our physical evidence of who we were.
Right.
This is how we find out what we are to do.
I'm saying it wrong.
Read the. I'm showing you real quick. Read this.
Jeremiah chapter 17 verse 4.
Bring it up.
And thou, even thyself, shalt discontinue from thine heritage that I gave thee.
What is the heritage that he gave us? He gave us the land, he gave us the laws, he gave us the world. There is nowhere, anywhere that you walk on this earth is supposed to be yours.
I'm with you.
This right here is supposed to be your property right now. But because we didn't keep these commandments, this doesn't belong to us now.
Now you will see the trimmer of God. We are not black men, we are the Israelites.
saying that I'm a black man. I ain't saying that no more. It sounds wrong, man.
This is Bishop Nathaniel of Israel United in Christ. Please subscribe to our YouTube channels. Stay up to date with our latest events, music, and classroom lessons. IUIC plans to continue visiting different countries where this gospel has not been preached before. IUIC needs your help in pushing this truth. So join us. Subscribe to our Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, and podcast, and stay up to date with us. For more information, please visit www.israelunite.org.